I've lived in a number of different places in my lifetime. I grew up in Windsor and Detroit, and I lived in Calgary and Edmonton, and then I lived out in Seattle, Washington, and I pastored there, and I've been in a lot of places, a lot of contexts, but I've been in Markham for 23 years now, and I've seen so much. And Markham is not altogether different than any other town or city in Canada. There are needs. We have people who are hurting. We have people who have been traumatized in one way or another. There's domestic abuse. There are new immigrants that are traumatized by a new land and trying to figure out how to make their way. There's people who have given up and are so lonely and so forlorn and so hurt, and that they've given up. I attended several suicides throughout my time with both the Markham Fire Department and with the Bridge Church. And it's been heartbreaking to see 15-year-olds take their life, or to see the parents of that 15-year-old have to make their way into their future, living down that reality and that trauma in their lives. Jesus says that our faith is to somehow translate into you and I being the light of the world, or the salt of the world. And the Bridge exists for that purpose of illuminating where the hope comes from, illuminating where truth comes from. The whole purpose of our building project is to create a greater functional space that allows us to be with people in their hurts, to be with people in their learning, in their growth, to be with people in their trauma, to be with people in their families, to be with people in the midst of their transformation and change as God loves on them. This building campaign is simply you and I being sacrificial towards making these things real, and towards the development of our presence in a community that is so in need. That's why we're in this campaign. In this building project, we will be doubling our space for children, youth, young adults, and adding about 40% more space for our adult population in our worship experiences. So we're definitely doing something quite practical and quite helpful for the future that we believe in. We're also going to be having more classroom space for our seasonal groups, more grouping space for each one of our ministries, because we believe that we are a gather, group, give and go church. That's who we are. That's what we do. And we'll have the space to do it well. We're imagining over 2,000 people making their way through our church any given week, being touched, ministered to, healed, transformed, and impacted with the truth of who Jesus is. The Bridge is a conduit of love. And the way in which love gets expressed is through sacrifice. And it's through you and I being willing to be selfless. And this campaign is going to facilitate that process in our lives. We get to be selfless as we raise $1.5 million. We get to sacrifice. We get to set aside our own wants and desires and join with God in meeting some needs in this community, in providing truth, in bringing warmth, in dispelling loneliness. We get to do all of these things, you and I together. What an exciting thing to be a part of. So if you want to get involved, if you want to be a part of this campaign, go to buildinghope.ca. There you will find some materials that will help you engage and get involved. At buildinghope.ca, there are some pledge cards there for you. There are some devotional materials that will help you sort through and get to a place where you've made a decision as to what it is that you will give. And there will be daily, if not weekly, updates as to what is happening in this building project.